In this video, we're going to talk a little bit more about raster graphics, and we're going to talk about the considerations when you select a raster image. One of those considerations is the resolution of the image. Right now, I'm looking at my desktop. If I right-click on my desktop, I can look at the desktop properties, I can look at the settings tab, and I can see that my screen resolution is 1024 by 768 pixels. If I do a search for an image on the web and wish to make the image my background, I can go to Google. Let's say I'm a fan of NASA and I like pictures of space, so I'm going to do a search for space. When I do a search, it comes back with a whole bunch of web pages. What I really want to see is I want to see images, so I can go up to the images link at the top of Google. Do a search for images. I want to limit my results to links that are coming back from NASA. So I can type the command site colon and then nasa.gov, and it will limit my search to pictures that are coming back from the nasa.gov website. So let's say I find an image here I like. I'll click on it. I'll see the full size image. And then in Firefox, I can right click on the image and I can set it as my desktop background. And let's say I stretch it to fit the entire background and hit Set Background. Now, you'll notice what happens here is that the image really isn't a high enough resolution to be stretched across my background. When I look at the image, it says it's 404 pixels by 333 pixels, while my desktop is 1024 pixels by 768 pixels. So what I should really do is I should look for an image that's appropriate to the resolution I'm going to use it as. So I'm going to go back to Google, and this time I'm going to add another command to my search, and I'm going to say image size colon, and then I'll type in 1024 by 768. Now when I'm searching for images, I'm finding images that are going to be appropriate for my resolution. And again, I can set it as my backdrop. And now I have an image on my background that looks good because it's the right resolution. By the same token, you need to keep this in mind when you're using graphics inside your Microsoft Office products. You may decide to use graphics that are not sized appropriately for the resolution you're displaying them at. They're not sized appropriately to be scaled up. They're not sized appropriately to be printed, etc. We're going to talk about using images from the web. And specifically, we're going to talk about a couple of formats. One format we'll talk about is GIF. So I'm going to insert a text box. We'll say GIF images. GIF images have some pros, such as animation and transparency. They also have some cons, which are a limited number of colors. The other format we'll talk about really briefly is we'll talk about PNGs. PNGs have some pros, such as lossless compression and transparency. They have some cons, such as larger file sizes than JPEGs. Now, I've created two headings here. If I want to wrap these, I can do that. I can make the boxes a little smaller. I can select my text here. I can make them bullets. Now, let's say I want to take these two text boxes and I want to position them next to each other. And I want to line them up. I'm not sure if I have them actually lined up. So I can actually select both of these at the same time. Go to the Arrange icon on the Home ribbon and say Align. And I can line them, align top, and then they'll line up for me. So let's say I find a GIF image on the web. For example, let's say that I've gone to the Wikipedia article about GIF images. So I find this GIF animation right here that shows a Newton's cradle. So I'm going to click on this. So I see a larger version of it. Now, I can right-click on an image and copy it. But this has some limitations. If I paste this image into my presentation, it looks okay. But when I go into slideshow mode, I'll notice that it's no longer a animation. If I go back to my image and I save the image as a file, let's say I save it to my desktop, and then I go to the insert ribbon and click on picture and go to my desktop, I can open the image from my desktop. Now notice that when I go to slideshow view, it retains its quality as an animation. So there are significant differences in how you might bring images into PowerPoint, which will dictate their behavior. Again, I can create another text box. I can use the align feature to align them to each other. I can align left. I can select one of the pictures and the text and use that to align top. Let's now compare a PNG image that also has a special feature with transparency. I'm going to search on Wikipedia for a PNG format, which is portable network graphics, and I'm going to take a look at this example of PNG. One of the benefits of PNG is what's called alpha transparency, which means it devotes a large amount of information to a transparency channel. And I'm going to copy this image and I'm going to paste it in PowerPoint. And notice what happened to the transparency. We lost the transparency when I copy and pasted. So I'll take the same image, and instead of copying and pasting it, I'm going to go and save it. So I'll do save image as, save it to my desktop. Go back into PowerPoint, click on insert ribbon, click on picture. Find my PNG on my desktop and open it. And you'll notice that as I move this image over top of this black background, it still remains transparent. So if you're pulling images from the web, you can save them from the web and preserve some of their special features. Or if it's a simple image and you do not care about transparency or animation, you can just simply copy it from a web page. Now the format you'll see most commonly on the web is the JPEG format. JPEGs offer very good compression, resulting in smaller file sizes, and they show a very large number of colors. Going back to Wikipedia, the problem with a JPEG image compared to other image formats is JPEG has what's called a lossy compression. If you look up lossy compression on Wikipedia, they've got a great example that shows an original image and then how that original image degrades when it's used with more and more compression. You've probably seen many images like this when you've surfed the web that have been overcompressed, and it results in a very small picture size, but also a very poor picture quality.